And speaking of pay gaps, female employees at Britain's Tesco supermarket group are seeking back pay, claiming they were paid much less than their male counterparts for similar jobs. Reports say it could result in a $5.6 billion payout for that company and impact nearly 200,000 employees. A law firm representing dozens of workers has taken legal action against the company. Tesco says it works hard to pay its employees fairly. And Paula Lee joins us now from London. She's an associate solicitor at Leigh, the legal firm handling the Tesco case. Thanks so much for being with us.
That's a pleasure.
So this is a record equal pay claim involving women workers at Tesco. How much less are women currently being paid compared to their male counterparts? And how likely is it that your law firm will win this case against Tesco?
Okay, so the women in the stores are paid on average £8 per hour, and the men in the distribution centres, our research shows, are paid around about £11 an hour. So we think that how things currently stand, is about a £3 per hour differential. I think your latter question is, do we think that we'll win? Well, yes, we do think the prospects of success for the women are good. We think they're strong. Equal pay claims, though, are notoriously long-winded. They are complex. There's a lot of hurdles to cross in order to be successful, and Tesco are a very sophisticated employer, and I'm sure they'll defend it quite hard. But yes, we are confident of showing that the work between the women that's undertaken on the shop floor and that work undertaken by the men in the distribution centres is of equal value and should be paid the same.
Yeah, I mean, they will be working hard to save themselves more than $5 billion. It's quite an extraordinary number, isn't it? But Tesco says it works very hard to pay its employees fairly. What do you say to that?
Yeah, I think that's right. I think Tesco, if you look at their website, they have been interrogating pay between the genders since 2002. And in 2011, they signed up to this country's government's Think, Act, Report initiative. And I think everyone is very comfortable with the idea of men and women working side by side, doing the same job, being paid the same. That, however, is not this case. This case is looking at work of equal value. And the law in England permits women, predominantly women, to compare their different job with that undertaken by men. And if that job is of equal value, and we can show that, then they're entitled to equal pay. So when you hear employers saying, we always pay equal pay for equal work, I think they're mainly talking about side-by-side work, and I think everyone is comfortable with that. We're looking at different jobs, and we're interrogating those different jobs, and we say they are of equal value and should be paid appropriately, and our law permits that.
Right. And how often is this happening in other companies across Britain? Does your law firm have plans to work hard for women at some of those other companies where there is a disparity in male and female pay?
Oh, absolutely. So we currently represent a number, about 20,000 female shop workers for Asda supermarket, which is owned by Walmart, of course. We've got over 1,000 women in the Sainsbury's litigation. So in this country, we saw it quite a lot in the public sector throughout the early noughties. Now, the equal pay issue that we're talking about here is now coming into the private sector. And so we've got multiple thousands of women that we are representing in this discussion.
All right, Paula Lee, thank you so much for joining us and explaining all of that to us. Appreciate it.